trapped in the Aquanet. This song's called I Remember You Were Wild.
I dreamt of castles, Sundays by the seaside. I saw the trestles, turning tide, and Tommy marches on, but you don't play along. I'm once again beguiled. I remember you were wild, always acting like a child. I was the earth, you were the sky. Yeah.
This song is called Ventriloquist.
Open my mouth, but I cannot speak on. I'm carrying a heavy heart. There's 10 equations for a brand new start. And walking around in the scattered leaves on. And feeling like there's no one at all who cares about me. Like there's no one at all who's speaking for me. Golden amethyst, every path a new way to exist. Wind whipping through the naked trees, I'm planted in the ice and snow. But it's coming slow on. And feeling like there's no one at all who cares about me. It seems like there's no one at all who's speaking for me.
This song's called Caroline, and it's for every woman named Caroline who's ever been mentioned in the history of song ever, named Caroline, or in a song that's about a woman named Caroline. Caroline, no, sweet Caroline. Caroline says, oh, Caroline, on and on.
Caroline, yeah, you've been sung about so many times.
talking with Gene out on the street. And I don't know where you are half the time, but you were always somewhere there in the back of my mind, Caroline. If you were mine, Caroline, Caroline, Caroline. I always thought we would be man and wife. Be so good, be so fine, to immortalize a loving kind. And though I never had you for my own, well, you made so many other grown men moan, Caroline. If you were my Caroline. A light's been written and I sent a card in the post. I guess I'm smitten, you're the one that I need the most, Caroline.
I'm Derek for Crowded Magazine, and I'm here with Kelly Stoltz and his band, Rob, Rusty, Kevin, and Jamin. And they just played an awesome set for us, and they were nice enough to stick around and answer a few questions. So welcome, guys. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I guess we'll get started with kind of a general question of how you guys kind of fell in love with music and knew that that's what you wanted to do. Was there maybe a particular album or band or person that inspired you and made you go, like, when you were a kid and say, that's music, that's what I want to do?
I can answer that one.
Go for it.
I was 3 years old, and my sister gave me an Elvis Presley single, and when I heard that, that was it. I just knew exactly what I wanted to do from that moment on.
Elvis?
Yep.
Anybody else have a...
Do the twist in the living room?
It was a Hound Dog, and Don't Be Cruel. Ooh. I was jumping around all over the place.
Wow.
I think it was Ace Frehley for me.
Ace He's Frehley. Right over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, for me, it was the White Album. I was 2 years old, and my dad had some really good speakers, and that was it.
Well, the first I... was intrigued by mostly gay music at the beginning. It was Queen and the Village People, and ABBA, which I only learned later, had such a deep root in the in gay culture. But from there, I moved on into heterosexual music made by David Bowie and Elton John and folks like that. And later, it was... I had a stepbrother who was heavily into English new wave post-punk music. So it was like Echo and the Bunnymen, the Smiths, New Order and bands like that. And those were probably the first bands that I really loved and wanted to be like, and, you know, got hairspray and stuck my hair up and wore long black trench coats and started to smoke cigarettes so that I could kind of be like them. That was probably... when I realized that being a musician could be cool.
John Lennon.
There you go.
What about you, Jamin? Was it?
I started playing violin when I was about six, after seeing my mother in...
Oh, sorry.
After seeing my mother in a production of Fiddler on the Roof. And I played that for about 2 years.
Yeah, it sucked.
That was the last time I touched anything with a string on it.
Wow. Cool.
Except shoes.
Tennis racket.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shoes.
Well, Kelly, you mentioned Echo and the Bunnymen as being an influence, and anybody that's kind of followed you for a while now knows that you know, kind of did your track by track Crocodiles
right.
cover album.
Right.
And you guys actually just got off a tour with Echo and the Bunnymen. I'm kind of curious how that all went and how it all came about. And I guess for you in particular, that was a dream come true.
It really was a dream come true for me. It came about a year ago, the Icelandic volcano exploded for the first time, or there have been two, I guess, separate volcano explosions or eruptions. And the first one that erupted last April caused a lot of mayhem over the Atlantic Ocean for planes. And so the band that they had scheduled to open a tour for them was not able to come to the United States. And they were playing at Coachella. And I'd become friends with them over many years of stalking and, you know, personal fan messages and waiting around outside of hotels and things like that growing up. And so they knew I lived in San Francisco and had a group. And when their opening band wasn't able to make the whole U.S. tour, they called me. And they were playing the Fillmore the next night. I think they called me on a... Now, they called me on a Saturday with a vague, "Are you in town?" on my voicemail. And I thought maybe that was going to be an invitation to come see the show or something. But Sunday morning, they called and said, "We need an opener for this tour that starts tomorrow at the Fillmore and then leaves immediately for Chicago the next day. So could you do it?" So Kevin, who's been in my band the longest of anybody, I called him and, you know, said, "Can you go?" And he said, "Yeah." And then I got a hold of Rusty, or Rusty was my roommate at the time. And so I think they all knew it was a really important moment in my life and they would have to drop everything to accommodate my dream. So I was very thankful they were able to go along. So we did that tour around the States, and then they invited us to go to England in December, and we played a bunch of shows with them there, about 8 shows in England, and then they wanted us to come along again around the States this time. So I think one of the stories that I related to the crowd was that growing up I'd seen them about 12 or 13 times, and then this year alone we played with them 30 times, so it was kind of interesting.
Cool.
They're nice guys and were supportive of my music and stuff, and it was a real thrill.
Have you had any motivation to do another cover album?
Of anybody else?
Of anybody else?
Or
another one of Echo and the Bunny
I've Men. Actually done 3 of the Bunny Men's first 4 records, and I only released Crocodiles. I did have Heaven Up Here, which is their second record, and I burned about 100 of those and sold those along the tour. And those, you know, were outselling my own records about 3-1, which was kind of a problem. But nonetheless, it was a little bit of gas money and stuff. But I don't know. I've always done covers over the years, but I'm not sure what it will be next.
Do you guys have any interest in, if you could do an album, what would you do? Like,
from beginning to end?
Yeah, from front to back cover album.
I do Below the Branches.
It's a good one.
Huey Lewis, Sports.
Oh, yeah. I'm in. Neil Diamond, Hot August Nights Live.
Cool.
John Wayne, Texas Funeral.
Yeah. Cool. And Kelly, you've been kind of recording for well over a decade now, and I'm wondering is there a conscious sense of growth in where for like you were on Two Dreamers and Antique Glow, do you notice anything, or do you still feel like the same, like a kid making music still? And
I guess the general feeling of joy that I get from it and the way time flies when I'm in my room doing it is still the same. When I started, I had just a Tascam 388 machine and one microphone, kind of like this, and one acoustic and one electric, and a really crappy amp, and one of those double-decker grandma organs. And I remember then I used to stick this mic in between 2 dresser drawers and then close them and then stand up real close with the guitar. That was my mic stand. So I think if anything, I've made a little money through music and been able to buy better equipment. So
a real mic stand.
A real mic stand, you know, and some nicer guitars and microphones. And Kevin's been a really good friend and kind of a mentor to me with recording since I started. So I've learned a lot from him. So I think the songs are better, and I think the sounds I get are better. The happiness I get from it's pretty much the same.
Cool. And I guess speaking to that kind of experience and wisdom over the years, if you guys could go back and tell yourselves 15 years ago, one kind of piece of advice, do you have anything you would say about the music business or about making music? Or
I just would have played.
more?
I didn't start playing music until like 3 years ago. I took like, 30 years off or something.
I would probably say don't get hung up in the process. Just try to have fun doing it because, ultimately, that's really what you're going to be. Remember, the good times you had with friends doing it.
Cool. I think that's good words of wisdom. And I guess to kind of close things up, you guys played a song that doesn't have a home yet, Caroline. And I'm wondering, are you headed back in the studio or is there a new album on the way or what's next for Kelly Stoltz and you guys?
Well, I just moved, changed my living situation. So I'm getting I have a garage now that's getting converted into a music studio. So all of my stuff is in boxes and has been for a month and a half because we've been on this tour and with moving and stuff. So I've got a lot of ideas in my head and I've been singing songs into my phone a little bit, which is a whole new level of recording. And so I just have a lot of ideas, but nothing really. That one just came along at the last week when I was still at my old apartment and had my stuff there set up and, fiddled around with that song. But we've been so busy traveling or unpacking boxes or packing or painting or whatever that I haven't had much time to do much with music. But as soon as I have a place to set everything up, I'll get back to it. And hopefully something will come along in the next year.
Cool. Well, you can catch the rest of the entire session with Kelly Stoltz and the guys. And also check out we have an exclusive of Caroline and look for it on the next record, whenever that may be.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye out there.